Okay, I'm just going to show you a little bit on the editing and the effects that I use when I'm trying to do different things on my video. I'm going to show you a page on YouTube, the guy that actually gives these filters out. He does them, and he's done a good job, and so you can go check him out. But this is what I do when I'm starting to get into it. This is Vegas Pro 12. I'll come up here to all media, click that. Find all the videos that I want from any particular session that I've been working on, then open them. And once I've opened them, here they are. So from here, what I'll do is I'll drag down, and then I can start obviously playing, etc., etc. But sometimes what I want to do straight away is, this is the very first thing, that if I know I'm going to be doing a few cuts, what I'll do is I'll separate the sound from the soundtrack from the video track. And to do that, you go on the audio track at the bottom, you right click, come up to group, and then remove from, and then that separates that. And you can rejoin it anytime you want, but you know, that's generally what I do when I'm first messing around. From here, for your video, you can, you know, there's a couple of different stuff you can do. You can mess around with them, because everything in here, well, more or less, as far as I'm aware, you can actually do on you know, the individual tracks. So, but if you want to join them again, click the control button, highlight them both, and come back and group them again, so they'll stay like that. As I say, Car and Biker did a video, a few basic stuff, and that's great for a lot of people. Because we all need help, we don't know what we're doing half the time. So if you want to split the track, for me, I just select where I want it splitting, hit S on my keyboard, and it separates it. And yeah, you can overlap them and stuff. So anyway, let's get back. I'm just pressing edit undo just to get that back. Now then, if I want to do an effect, let's say I'm splitting, so I'll do two splits here. Okay, so I've come here, and I'll just run through. Now this bit, this bit here that I've separated, I want to do a separate effect on that, this bit here. So what do I do? Okay, I come in here and I press this event effects button, and that comes up with all these effects. Now these effects are ones that I've downloaded, and I'll show you where you can get these very soon. And there's quite a few that you can play with. I'll just give you, for instance, let's find one with letterbox, chill with letterbox. So you'll click on that, you'll click OK. Now then, that should be on that, so let's have a look. And there you are, you see, you've got your letterbox. So you've gone from no letterbox, which is at the top and the bottom of the picture, to having a letterbox. And that's also changed the cinema style of that, because it comes with that. So you see, that's that, and that's a good effect. Now, to alter these bars, the top and the bottom, you can alter them, you can make them wider, whatever. You've just got to find the pan crop there, not the pan crop, gradient, there's one of them. Let's see if we can find it, cookie cutter. So you've got your cookie cutter, and you've got your, what do you call it? Now if you watch the black bars, you'll see them disappear, they'll come normal, and you can mess around with the effects there on that. Got your size, make them disappear, etc., etc. It's just to get that film look. So you can do that, and you know, you click in the gas. If you don't want it, you just click remove and it's gone. You can see that, because that's what that little green thing is for. So anyway, getting that back, you can go into all your different ones that you want, and just mess around to your heart's content. You've got all different types, styles, the ones that he likes to. Let's try this matrix with letterbox. Let's have a look at that, see what that looks like. Some of them you might think, it's not good. But some of them really do stand out. So it's just a case of playing and having a bit of a mess around. Hot August sunset. So you get the ones that you like. And basically cooking with gas on them. Once you've got that done, try it now on August sunset. So there you go. Slows down a bit, but that's it. When it's rendered, it don't judder. It actually does it proper. Let's have a look. Let's turn down. Got the best. Try it preview auto. A lot better. So anyway, where you get these effects from is, I'll just show you now. Let's get up here, and the guy, his name is 95 Turbo Soul. He's out there in America somewhere, and these are the kind of effects that he does. So leave it up to you. And when I discovered them, I thought they were absolutely cracking effects. And to be able to load them into Sony, pretty good. And it explains how to install them and everything. So, you know, it's not as if you're going to be left high and dry and wondering how do I do it. It's pretty simple. And you can see the effect there. It's really good. So, 95 Turbo Soul. Go over there and check out his filters and get them downloaded. And he goes into it all, and he's got quite a few different filters on his homepage. So that's done. And as I say, you can get back, do all the editing that you want, put them in. You can even have your fades going in, same as you did normal, and that comes into your you know, at the start of your clip, etc., etc. Have it going out, do what you want, and there you go. You see, so if that's helped anybody out, good stuff. Let me know if you think it's any good. Who knows?